Let all those to be confirmed please stand. Bishop Burbidge, I present to you our sons and daughters who are candidates for the sacrament of confirmation. Under the guidance of their parents and catechists, and with the prayerful support and the encouragement of this parish, they have been prepared to complete their initiation into the body of Christ, the Church, which was begun at their baptism. I ask that you impose hands upon them and anoint them with the sacred chrism, sealing them with the gift of the Holy Spirit. And now, I ask you, the community of Our Lady of Good Counsel Parish, gathered here to show your support and acceptance of these candidates with your consent and with your applause.
Sacrament of Confirmation, I had a chance to meet briefly with them before Mass today. I can see why you're all so very proud of them, wonderful young men and women, and certainly prepared in their faith. I asked them all kinds of questions about our Catholic faith. They were able to answer every one of them, so we can spend this time seeing the sponsors know them too. But a word of thanks to you, their parents. You are the first teachers of your sons and daughters in the ways of faith, a beautiful vocation, responsibility God has given to you, dear parents, and one that you've taken seriously, because here they are tonight to be confirmed, fully initiated in our Catholic faith. I'm sure the Lord is well pleased with all of you. And dear sponsors, how honored you must feel that these young people see something special in you in the way you live your faith and practice your faith. They'd ask you to help them to do the same, to encourage them in their faith. And we thank you for accepting this great responsibility. Dear candidates, a great joy to be with all of you. You're confirmed in a very special month in the life of the Church, in the life of the diocese, the month of October, where here in the United States we call Respect Life Month. It's a powerful reminder to all of us of what we know to be true, that all of life, the very moment of conception to natural death, is sacred, holy, should be cherished and protected. The dignity of all human persons should be respected. But tonight reminds us that why that is true. I know you have a great love for St. Francis de Sales in this parish. He says that every person is God's work. That's what the Lord is reminding all of you tonight, dear young friends. He created you in his very image and likeness. Like St. Paul said today, he's giving you unique gifts and talents and personalities. And in just a few moments, as a fulfillment of his promise, when I outstretch my hands and say this very powerful prayer the Church gives us, he seals you, he sends down for you the gifts of the Holy Spirit. Think about that. You are temples of the Holy Spirit. That's why life is sacred. That's why it should be celebrated and protected. And right now, dear young friends, our Church, our nation, we need you. We need your generation more than ever to be witnesses to the gospel of life. And you will do so by the way you respect yourself, respect your own body by the way you respect other people. We are so proud of you. In October, here in the Diocese of Arlington, we just had what we call a diocesan pilgrimage. Over 2,000 people from around our diocese went to the Basilica Shrine in Washington, D.C. We gathered in faith. But one of the best parts of the day for me was at the end, we had a Eucharistic procession. Jesus was in the Blessed Sacrament. And we processed from the Basilica Shrine to the shrine of St. John Paul II. So we closed the street. And all of us were in a procession. But here's what I noticed. In the front of the procession was Jesus. We were carrying Jesus, and we were all following him. And isn't that what our faith life is all about? Jesus leads, we follow. And you're all going to remind us of that in a special way in just a few moments. I'm going to ask you to stand. You're going to renew your baptismal promises. They're serious questions. To each one, you will say, I do. Yes, Lord, you lead. I follow. But you know it's not always going to be easy. You know it right now in school, I'm sure. In your community, to do what's good and holy and pure. I bet sometimes you have to separate yourself from the crowd. I bet sometimes you might have to take the risk of being labeled or ridiculed. But you're saying it's okay. No matter what the cost is, I'm going to be faithful. But don't try it alone. Don't try it alone. Continue to be men and women who pray every morning and night. We ask God for the gifts of the Spirit to help you. Certainly come here every weekend to be nourished with the source of our strength, the gift of the Holy Eucharist. Because with those gifts, with God's strength, never a reason to be fearful. October is another special month for me because it's also the feast of another Francis. My confirmation name, Francis of Assisi. And I think he reminds us that as you are strengthened tonight as witnesses of the Lord, what we need you to be out there. You know his famous prayer, right? Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Isn't that what our world needs from you more now than ever? It's sad what we've been witnessing, isn't it? Violence, hatred, division, bigotry. So sad. Sometimes people will ask me, well, Bishop, what do we do in the midst of that? Well, we don't despair. We're believers who believe that the Lord has conquered the power of evil. And so what I think we should do is to say that prayer of St. Francis. Lord, wherever you send me, where there's hatred, let me bring love. Where there's darkness, let me bring light. Where there's injury, let me bring pardon. In other words, if your eyes are open, every day where God sends you, there's an opportunity for you to be an instrument of his peace. And so we pray for you tonight, dear friends. We pray that you will always be able to celebrate the precious gift of life itself. That you will always have the courage to make sure that in your life, Jesus leads and you follow. And that wherever he sends you, each and every day, you will try your best to be an instrument of his peace, so that we can live as God intended, as God's holy family, as brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, the one tonight who fills you with his very Spirit and promises to be with you forever. God bless you and protect you on this joyful night and all the days of your life. Amen. So, dear candidates, if you will now stand to renew your baptismal promises. Dear candidates, before you receive the Spirit, call to mind the faith which you profess in baptism, or which your parents and godparents profess with the church. And so, dear candidates, I now ask you, do you renounce Satan and all his works and all his empty promises? Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who tonight, through the sacrament of confirmation, is given to you in a special way, just as he was given to the apostles on the day of Pentecost? And do you believe in the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? This is our faith, This is the faith of the church, and we are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Dearly beloved, let us pray to God the Almighty Father for these, his chosen sons and daughters, already born again to eternal life in baptism, that he will graciously pour out the Holy Spirit upon them to confirm them with his abundant gifts, and through this anointing, conform them more fully to Christ, the Son of God. We now pray in silence for our candidates to be confirmed. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who brought these your servants to new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, free them from sin, send upon them, O Lord, the Holy Spirit, Paraclete. Give them the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and fortitude, the spirit of knowledge and piety. Fill them with the spirit of fear of the Lord, through Christ our Lord. Amen.